I'm just saying, if it's got a label on it, don't buy it until you actually read the label. You'd be surprised how many times you'll put something back that you were 99% sure you're gonna buy. After you read the label, you're just like, whoa, off it goes. Don't waste food, okay? And that goes actually to my last one, which was to compost. Make the best possible food choices according to your understanding. Before shopping, make a list. In other words, if it's not on your list, it's probably not edible. Grow something to eat, anything. Grow something to eat. Everybody here should be, in their home life, growing one food item. Grow anything. Grow a chive. I mean, come on. I mean, grow something. Grow anything. Anybody can grow a chia pet. You can eat them. Okay. Grow something. All right? It's about your consciousness. See, it brings consciousness. It brings energy, attention, consciousness, breath, and pressure is the imperative to change your environment. Grow something. Grow anything. Involve your family and friends, church, or social networking group in a food project, or join one. Edible should be part of that. Edible should be, everyone should compost. Make your food beyond interesting and nutritious. Listen, we got to be ninja. Okay, ninja. I'm a ninja for food. You know how I ninja, how I ninja raging carnivores into a plant-based diet? You know how I do it? Julie and I, we craft in the secret dark recesses of our attic with our candles and our sigils on the floor and our sacred tomes of secret knowledge, I mean recipe books, favorite recipe book, and we flip the pages and we recite the magic incantations of holistic, organic, local, fresh, seasonal ingredients, and we put them boil, toil, and trouble into our cauldron, our magic cauldron, and we put our own energy, we put our own sacred essence into that boiling cauldron of magic elixir, and we call it to allurement, we call it to glamour, and we call it to create life, and we call it to manifest our vision for the world as we see the swirl of the world inside that pot, and then we serve that on the table. And it's an irresistible force. And people are drawn to it. Oh. What is that? And Julie goes, dinner. And then they eat that. And they're like, whoa. You can see it. You can see it. You can see it. Trying to adjust. Trying to adapt, trying to encapsulate the idea that the most tasty thing that's ever crossed this inner and outer brain, this barrier, has no meat. And it's tasty, and it's medicine. And then they start to make these little adjustments. They want to know what's the, do you have a recipe? What are the ingredients? Is it hard to make? Oh no, you just throw some shit in a bowl and stir it up. It's easy. And then they start to do it. And next thing you know, you've saved a soul. You've got another person who is going to live a longer, healthier, happier life. Okay, well, thank you very much. I got to quit.
Thank you.